our hometown of Hopkins, 2000-2001 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Princess, Melanie Terrazas. And 2004-2005 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Princess, Lauren Paulson. Melanie has been a lifelong Hopkins Raspberry Festival volunteer. She and her husband Alex have a one-year-old son, Maxwell. Look for him at the 2013 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Coronation as a candidate on this stage. Lauren has been volunteering with the festival since her time as princess in various capacities. She is employed by Super Value in Eden Prairie and resides in Hopkins.
Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome. I'm Melanie Terrazas.
And my name is Lauren Paulson. Thank you for inviting us here to help celebrate the 76th annual Hopkins Raspberry Festival.
This evening, of course, we'll be saying farewell to our 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Royalty, and we will usher in the 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Royalty.
At this time, it is our pleasure to present you the 2009-2010 Junior Royalty.
Prince Jalen Tremel is escorted by his mom, Julie, and sister, Tasia. Junior Prince Jalen is the son of June Lee Tremel and Anthony Kennedy. He has two sisters and one brother. Prince Jalen goes to Alice Smith and will be in second grade this fall. His favorite part of school is gym, games, and seeing his friends every day. This year, he learned how to read and can read a book by himself. Jalen wanted to be a junior royalty candidate because his mom said it would be fun and he wanted to go to all the parades. I don't think he knew how many. His favorite event was the Raspberry Festival Parade because it was their first one and it was very exciting. They got to sit in the back of a convertible and everyone was so happy to see them. When Prince Jalen grows up, he's not sure what he wants to be, maybe a teacher or policeman. Going fishing with his mom, playing outside, finding frogs, and playing baseball are a few of the things Prince Jalen likes to do when he's not being a prince. He also enjoys going to the park and playing baseball with his dad. Ladies and gentlemen, Prince Jalen Tremel.
Now we have Princess Jenna Basdeo. She is being escorted by her mom, Renee, and sister, Kayla. Princess Jenna is the daughter of Renee and Richie Basdeo. Princess Jenna is the youngest in her family of two brothers and two sisters. Next fall, she will be a third grader at Gatewood Elementary. Her favorite part of school is reading because they have fun stories to figure out. This year, as the Raspberry Festival Junior Princess, Jenna most enjoyed the defeat of Jesse James Day because she got to see a bank raid reenactment and they had real horses. Princess Jenna wanted to be a junior royalty candidate because her mom inspired her to do so and she likes doing all the fun activities. Her favorite thing about the Raspberry Festival is that she got to ride in the parade in a convertible after she was crowned. When Princess Jenna grows up, she wants to be an artist so she can share her artwork with everyone. When Jenna is not being a Raspberry Princess, she enjoys playing outside, riding her bike, swimming, and playing with her friends. Ladies and gentlemen, Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Princess Jenna Basdeo.
Junior King Luke Endress is being escorted by his parents, Chris and Joseph. Junior King Luke is a student at Tanglin Elementary and will be in the fourth grade this fall. His favorite part of school is when they go on field trips. When Luke grows up, he wants to be an electrical or mechanical engineer so he can invent new things. Last year, King Luke wanted to be junior royalty candidate because he thought it would be fun to be a king and travel to other towns, meet new people, and be in parades. His favorite event was the Raspberry Festival Junior King was the Anoka Parade because of all the cool lights. King Luke's favorite part of the Raspberry Festival is Family Day because he likes eating mini donuts, getting balloon animals, and talking to people. When Luke is not being a king, he enjoys taekwondo, playing soccer or tennis, and having campfires with his family. Ladies and gentlemen, Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior King, Luke Endress.
And next we have Junior Queen Jada Gordon. She's being escorted tonight by her mom, Erica. Junior Queen Jada will be in fourth grade at Tanglin Elementary next fall. Her favorite part about school is music. Queen Jada has five brothers and sisters. Her favorite part of being the queen this year was the Aquatennial Parade because it was at night and all the floats were lit up. Queen Jada wanted to become a junior royalty candidate to meet new people and to be able to go to different places. Her favorite part of the Raspberry Festival is getting to ride on the float. When Queen Jada grows up, she wants to be a veterinarian so she can help animals. When she is not at Raspberry events, Queen Jada loves to ride her bike. Ladies and gentlemen, Queen Jada Gordon.
Your 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Royalty.
The royal family has done a great job working with the community this year. Juniors, please know that the Hopkins Raspberry Festival and the community of Hopkins are very proud of you. At this time, we would like to recognize the rest of the royal family.
We have 2009-2010 Princess Kirsten Raines, Princess Samantha Valdez, and Queen Megan Hinderman. Please welcome our outgoing senior ambassadors, John and Joan Markham. And thank you for your time and commitment over the past year to the festival.
We began our new Hopkins Raspberry Festival royal family last night at the Moonlight Serenade Senior Royalty Coronation Dinner and Dance. Please welcome the 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Senior Ambassadors, Alan and Judy Johnson. We are so excited for the adventure you are about to embark on.
We'd also like to introduce our young lady candidates. We have Paige Bolger, sponsored by Hopkins Elks. Jessica Hyde, sponsored by Max Liquor. Lindsay LaGrange, sponsored by Midwest Supplies. Brittany Palm, sponsored by MOC Pup Tent 15. And Daniel Steen, sponsored by Gina Maria's Pizza.
We would like to now introduce you to the 2010-2011 junior candidates. Might I say, each of them is absolutely adorable.
Of course, Lauren would say that.
Oh!
Each child will come on stage, escorted by his or her parents, draw a question from the basket to answer, and former Hopkins Raspberry Festival junior candidates, Sierra and Jada Bagstead, will hand them their trophies of accomplishment and special gift bags as they exit the stage. Let's go ahead and get started with candidate number one, Blake Anderson. Escorted by his father, Wayne Anderson, Blake is sponsored by Seabright Agency and Company, Inc. Blake would like to be a race car driver someday because he likes to drive fast and it looks fun. He also loves to play soccer and speaking Spanish. Silliest thing he's done was standing in his front yard and singing to music.
Hi, Blake. How are you today?
Good.
Are you excited to be here? All right, why don't you pick a question and hand it to me? All right. What is your favorite game to play and why?
I don't know.
Do you have anything you like to do, like sports, like baseball? And it's really fun because you get to play with other people, right?
Yeah.
Very cool. Thanks, Blake. And give a big wave. All right. We'll get your trophy.
Next, we have candidate number two, Grace Burgess. Escorted by her dad, Conrad, Grace is sponsored by Monk Beans Coffee and Sunshine Cafe. When Grace grows up, she would like to be a dancer because it makes her feel beautiful and graceful when she dances. The silliest thing she's ever done was chasing frogs at her cabin, even finding a few under some rocks.
Hi, Grace, how are you?
Good.
Are you excited to be here?
Mm-hmm.
Ready to pick a question? Mm-hmm. All right, dig in there and see what you get. Let's see. What is the silliest thing you have ever done and why?
I don't know.
What about, like, have you ever, like, dressed up in really funny clothes?
Yeah.
Yeah? Just for fun or to go somewhere in public?
Just for fun.
Yeah. And say and show your parents?
Mm-hmm.
And they laughed?
Yeah.
All right. Thanks, Grace. You can give a big wave.
And next we have candidate number three. Candidate number three? Mary.
Hi. Well, looky there.
Very nice. Hi, Barry. Barry.
Oh, thank you.
How are you today? Thumbs up. That's good. Well, do you want to play like the rest of the candidates are? All right. So let me think of a question for you here, and you can think real hard about this one, okay? What is the best community festival ever in the whole wide world?
I think Barry Barry wants some help.
What do you juniors think? All right, I'm gonna vote Hopkins Raspberry Festival too. Thanks, Barry Barry.
I'm pretty sure at some point Barry Barry has aged out. Thank you, Barry Barry. Next, we have candidate number 4, Eve Clarkson. Escorted by her father, Tim Clarkson, Eve is sponsored by Tim Clarkson, Van Clemens & Company. At school, Eve loves to learn about geography and learn about faraway places. She would love to be a tattoo artist because drawing on people would be really cool.
How are you, Eve?
Good.
Are you excited to be here?
Yes.
You ready to pick a question?
Yes.
Okay. What do we get?
What is your favorite thing to do in the summertime and why? I like going on my babysitter's boat and go tubing.
And go tubing?
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever fallen off a tube?
Yes.
Is it fun?
Yes.
Good. All right, thanks, Eve. Give a big wave for us. And then you can go back.
Next, we have candidate number 5, Anaya Elamin. Escorted by her mother, Jessica, Anaya is sponsored by the Elamin Fish House. Anaya would love to be a veterinarian when she grows up because she loves helping animals. She also loves math because you get to learn about big numbers. She loves to go to Shady Oak Beach, but always questions, am I big enough to go on the big diving board?
Hi, Anaya, how are you?
Good.
Are you excited to be here?
Yeah.
All right, let's pick a question. Let me see what you get. Who is your favorite teacher and why?
Miss Bilkey, because she's really nice and she teaches me things I never knew.
You never knew? That's so cool. Thanks, Anaya. Can you give a big wave?
Next, we have candidate number 6, Ashley Gish. Escorted by her mother, Debbie Gish, Ashley is sponsored by Maurice Traberg TTE. At school, Ashley enjoys science and all interesting hands-on experience. She loves swimming and camping, as well as dressing up in funny clothes and tackling her sister.
Hi, Ashley, how are you?
Good.
You excited?
Yeah.
Are you ready for the question?
Yeah.
All right, let's pick one and see what you get. Let's see. What is your favorite flavor of ice cream and why?
Lemon, because it's my favorite kind of ice cream.
Very cool, because it's like tart and fun?
Yeah.
All right, thanks, Ashley. A big wave. Thanks.
Now we have candidate number 7, Genevieve Henry. She's escorted by her dad, Matt, and is sponsored by Pinnacle Engineering. Genevieve says when she grows up, she would love to be a firefighter because she'll get a chance to help a lot of people, and firefighters are very brave. At school, she likes math the best. In the summer, she loves to swim because it cools you off.
Hi, Genevieve. How are you?
Good.
Are you excited?
Yes.
I like your dress. It's very pretty.
Thank you.
You want to pick a question? All right. Let's see what you got. What is your favorite kids movie and why?
Scooby-Doo.
What do you like best about it?
The characters.
Which one's your favorite?
Daphne.
Is she the one with the red hair in the purple outfit?
Yes.
She's cool. I like her too. Thanks, Genevieve.
Good job. Next, we have candidate number 8, Lillian Henry. Escorted by her dad, Matt, Lillian is sponsored by Pinnacle Engineering. Lillian remembers a funny time at her brother's birthday. They were playing pin the tail on the donkey. She couldn't see him and pinned her dad by accident, and later even called him Donkey. Her favorite game is playing butterflies with her friend Sienna because she gets to use her imagination.
Hi, Lillian. How are you?
Good.
Are you excited?
Yeah.
All right. Ready for the question time?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, pick one. All right. What do you want to be when you grow up and why?
Like all the jobs in the world.
Like every job?
Mm-hmm.
So how are you going to do every job?
Like when we get fired, I have to do a different job.
Oh, okay. That's great. Thank you, Lillian. Why don't you wave? Wave big.
Next, we have candidate number 9, Bryn Hirsch. Bryn is escorted by her mom, Christine Hirsch, and is sponsored by parents Ben and Christine Hirsch. Bryn's favorite colors are pink, purple, green, and blue. When she grows up, she'll be able to put those to good use because she wants to become an artist. Her favorite game is Disney's Seen It because it's fun, new, and exciting.
Hi, Bryn, how are you?
Good.
Good, I like your headband.
Thank you.
Are you excited to be here?
Yeah.
All right, why don't you pick a question? All right, what do we got here? If you could take a trip anywhere in the world, where would it be and why? Wouldn't cost you anything. You want to go to Disney World?
I've been there.
You've already been there. Where else could you go? What about like Hawaii? That'd be fun. Go sit on the beach.
Yeah.
Maybe Hawaii?
Yeah.
Okay. Sounds good. Thanks, Bryn. Give a big wave.
Now we have candidate number 10, Claire Nicholson. Escorted by her dad, Mike, Claire is sponsored by Advantage Agency Group, LLC. At school, Claire loves gym because they get to play lots of games. One of her favorites is chess. In the summertime, she loves roasting marshmallows at the cabin.
Hi, Claire, how are you?
Good, thank you.
Good, are you excited to be here?
Yes.
I like your dress, that's really pretty.
Thank you.
All right, you wanna pick a question? Good, mix it up a little. All right, what is your favorite subject in school and why?
My favorite subject is fall because I can jump in the leaves and
And they go crunch under your feet, right? Oh, I love fall. Thanks, Claire. Give a big wave.
Next, we have candidate number 11, Anthony Olson. He's escorted by his grandpa, Richard Olson, and is sponsored by grandparents Janet and Richard Olson. Anthony's favorite game is Star Wars because it's really cool. He wants to be a video programmer because he likes to make his own video games. He likes to go up north to Duluth and ride on four-wheelers.
Hi, Anthony, how are you?
Good.
Are you excited to be here?
Yes.
You ride four-wheelers?
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Will you dig a question out of here for me? All right, let's see what we got. What makes you laugh and why?
Being tickled.
Being tickled? What? Why do you giggle when you're tickled?
I don't know.
Because who doesn't, right? All right, thanks, Anthony. Give us a big wave.
Next, we have candidate number 12, Sam Rolls. Sam is escorted by Kevin and Chris Rolls and sponsored by Simulator Sports. At school, Sam loves recess. The silliest thing he did was kiss his stuffed animal. When he grows up, he wants to be a fireman so he can drive the fire truck. He wants to be junior king or prince so he can get a trophy and ride on the float with Jeff Dulac.
How are you, Sam?
Good.
Are you excited for today?
Yeah.
Do you want to grab a question? Let's see what we got here. What is your favorite sport and why?
Soccer.
And what do you like about soccer?
Because I want to be a goalie.
You want to be a goalie? Are you good at stopping goals?
Yeah.
Then you should be a goalie. Thanks, Sam. Give us a big wave.
Next, we have candidate number 13, Victoria Schrake. She's escorted by her father, Tom Schrake, and sponsored by B Elements Consulting, LLC. When Victoria grows up, she wants to be a veterinarian so she can help take care of small animals. The silliest thing she ever did was dressed up in her puppy in doll clothes and took pictures.
Hi, Victoria, how are you?
Good.
Are you excited to be here?
Yes.
I love your dress. I want one. Can you pick a question for me? All right, let's see what we got here. What is your favorite animal and why?
Bears.
What do you like about bears? They're kind of scary, I think. But,
I don't know.
They're big and furry. That's fun. Maybe. All right, well, thank you, Victoria. Why don't you give us a big wave?
And we have candidate number 14, Mia Wilcox. Escorted by her grandfather, Steve Thrapp, Mia is sponsored by Lillian's of Hopkins. Mia loves school, she attends a French immersion school, and loves speaking French. She once took a bath with her dog and said it was messy. When she grows up, she wants to be an artist.
Very nice. How are you, Mia?
Good.
Are you excited to be here?
Yes.
All right, there's two questions left, so you got to pick the good one, all right? Let's see what we got. What is your favorite cookie and why?
My favorite cookie is chocolate chip because I love chocolate.
Who doesn't? That's a good cookie. Thanks, Mia. Give us a big...
That was a great group of kids. We're actually going to bring them all back out for something special they prepared. They've all worked really hard on this, but first let's give them a round of applause for answering all their questions so well with Lauren.
Can you guys give one big last raspberry wave for us? Thank you, guys. Amazing. All right, candidates, you can go back off stage and you'll go sit with your parents for the rest of the program. Thank you. This will conclude the judging for the junior candidates and leave the judges with a very difficult decision to make. Candidates, you really did do a fantastic job.
We'd like to recognize our judges who spent time judging the junior candidates at the art night, fashion show, meet the candidates, private interviews, and this coronation.
We will begin with Missy Wilson. Originally from Crystal, Minnesota, she was the 2004-2005 Miss Robbinsdale Princess and Miss Congeniality. She has been part of the Robbinsdale Whiz Bang Days as a candidate coordinator and a volunteer ever since. She is currently busy coordinating the Midwest Queens program for the Minneapolis Aquatennial. Missy works for Mansell Services in Maple Grove as a senior program manager where she assists people with developmental disabilities and teaches basic skills to stay independent in the community. She enjoys spending time with her family, being outdoors either landscaping or exercising, and crocheting. Missy bought a home in Elk River 4 years ago and wed her high school sweetheart, Matt, who's here tonight, by the way. Yay.
Don Moore is an ambassador coordinator for St. Louis Park Parktacular. He's a longtime volunteer for the Minneapolis Aquatennial and St. Paul Winter Carnival. He's been a parade director for Winter Carnival for the past 3 years. Don was Sergeant of the King's Guard in 2006 and is a director of the Order of the Royal Guard organization. He's also in charge of the Aquatennial Queen of the Lakes candidate float and making sure it's ready and safe for the Torchlight Parade. In addition to designing, building, and repairing various floats over the years, Don has been judging ambassador and royalty programs in many communities for the past 12 years.
Next, we have Sarah Flynn. She's a lifelong resident of the community of Richfield. She's the youngest daughter of Peter and Lois Flynn and has two older siblings, Ryan and Catherine. Sarah works as a junior golf instructor at Minnesota Valley Country Club. This fall, she will be returning to the University of St. Thomas, where she will be in her sophomore year. Working towards degrees in economics and finance. Sarah enjoys spending time with her family and friends, playing golf or tennis, and reading a good book. Sarah was the 2008-2009 Richfield Ambassador and part of the Minneapolis Aquatennial Queen of the Lakes program. She's a member of the Richfield Ambassador Committee and just successfully completed the 4th of July Festival.
Andrew Foreman, the 1995-1996 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Prince, is excited to be back involved with the festival as a junior candidate judge. He's the son of Ron Foreman and Vicki Stamey, younger brother of Allison. Andrew is a recent graduate of St. Cloud State University with a degree in business management. He is currently working at SuperValu Corporate as a vendor-supported analyst. Andrew enjoys spending time playing softball, fixing up his house, going to concerts, and taking care of his bull mastiff, Honey, and border collie, Derby. When Andrew was the junior prince, he enjoyed having his good friend Spencer Smith as the junior king. He can still remember them dressing up as pigs for the Anoka Halloween parade. Andrew's favorite memories include fun times at parades, waving on the float, and meeting all the pretty girls in crowns.
And finally, we have Judy Villar. Judy and her husband Glenn currently reside in Richfield with their two daughters, Mindy and Shelby, three foster daughters, Angela, Lisa, and Teresa, and three dogs and a cat. Judy worked as a social worker for the last 20 years and is now a full-time foster parent. Judy has an older son who is a police officer for the city of Shakopee, and she is looking forward to becoming a grandmother in the next few short weeks. She is a former Mrs. Minnesota America in 1998 and has previously judged the Miss Monticello program from 1995 through 1999. She is no stranger to the festival world, as her daughter Mindy was the 2009-2010 Richfield Junior Ambassador. Judy is a member of the Richfield Ambassador Committee and the Junior Ambassador Coordinator. She has fond memories of the Hopkins Raspberry Festival, eating fresh raspberry sundaes, and watching the parade with the awesome Hopkins Float. Thank you, Judy.
We appreciate the time the judges have put into the festival, and actually Lauren is not only the MC tonight, she's also this year's judging coordinator for the festival. Thank you, Lauren, for your hard work.
Oh, thank you. It was easy with them, so.
And as the candidates sing this song, the judges are really in a crunch. So at this time, you're excused to make your final decision.
All right. Each year, the festival is put together by a group of individuals from the area that volunteer their time, creativity, and expertise. The junior program would like to thank all of you for your endless efforts. Could the Hopkins Raspberry Festival Board of Directors, coordinators, and volunteers please stand and be recognized?
A very special thank you to the Hopkins Raspberry Festival volunteers that work directly with the Junior Candidate Program, with Jeff Dulac, Lugene Gleason, Carrie Wright, Bonnie Harris, Ashley Harris, Marcus, Sue Normandin, Elizabeth Butler, Terry Burgess, Molly Nicholson, Juliana Clarkson, Kelly Lowry, Julia Wilcox, Gail Anderson, and all the junior candidates, both current and past, all the junior candidates' parents, both current and past, for assisting during the junior events this year.
Thank you. And we also have a big thank you to the individual who has coordinated this entire event and all of the other junior program events mentioned earlier. Stephanie Bagstead, will you please stand and be recognized? Thank you for all you do for the festival. It really is greatly appreciated.
We'd also like to extend a heartfelt thank you to all the local businesses that give time, talent, money, and services to the Hopkins Raspberry Festival. We'd like to especially thank the following businesses: Seabright Agency, Inc.,
Unca Beans Coffee and Sunshine Cafe,
Tim Clarkson, Van Clemens & Company,
Al Amin Fish House,
Maurice Treberg, TTE,
Pinnacle Engineering,
parents Peter and Christine Hirsch,
Advantage Agency Group, LLC,
grandparents Janet and Richard Olson,
Stimulator Sports,
B Elements Consulting, LLC,
Glenrose Floral,
Lillians of Hopkins,
Blake Antiques,
Main Street Consignment,
Baker Square,
McDonald's,
Peekaboo Studio,
Perkins,
Gina Maria's,
and A1 Moving. Without generous donations, the festival would not be possible, and we thank those businesses for their valuable support.
At this time, we have a very special guest singing a song, Almost There, from The Princess and the Frog. Please welcome Paris Curry to the stage.
Time for dancing. That's just gonna have to wait a while. Ain't got time for messing around, and it's not my style. This old town can slow you down, people taking the easy way. But I know exactly where I'm going, getting closer and closer every day, and I'm almost there. I'm almost there. People down here think I'm crazy, but I don't care. Trials and tribulations, I've had my share. There ain't nothing gonna stop me now, 'cause I'm almost there. I remember Daddy told me fairy tales can come true. You gotta make them happen, it all depends on you. So I'll work real hard each and every day, knowing for sure things are going my way. Just doing what I do, look out boys, I'm coming through, and I'm almost there. I'm almost there. People gonna come here from everywhere, 'cause I'm almost there. I'm almost there. There's been trials and tribulations, you know I've had my share. But I've climbed the mountain, I've crossed the river, and I'm almost there. I'm almost there. I'm almost there.
Thank you, Paris. This time we will welcome the current reigning royalty to give their farewell speeches. Please welcome 2009-2010 Princess Kirsten Raines, Princess Samantha Valdez, and Queen Megan Hinderman.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. Good evening. Glad you guys came. I'm going to talk about Jalen and Luke. Again, I'm Hopkins Raspberry Festival Princess Kirsten Raines, and I'm just going to go ahead. All right. To my boys, Luke and Jalen, you guys have grown so much this year. Luke, my most memorable moment with you was when you were trying to get rid of your tooth on the float after Jenna lost her tooth. Your fun and shaking and dancing ways this year are phenomenal. I want to thank his parents, Chris and Joseph, for everything that they have done, from fixing the float seats to the sashes. Thank you, guys. Wherever you, oh, thank you. Jalen, I'm sorry, I'm just going to cry. You're the most quiet child I've ever met in my life. And I love that about you. And also, I love that you have the ability to find either a frog or an insect at almost every parade or an event. I've never seen you come to an event or a parade or anything without smiling. I'll cherish that forever. I also want to thank his sister, Tasia, and his mother, Julie, for everything. You guys have, every situation, you guys are always there, ready and prepared. I hope to see you guys grow into wonderful young men that I have, that I know you are. I'm sorry. Though you didn't always agree with me when I stopped the machine, the merry-go-round machine, because you guys wouldn't wave and smile through hot and cold parades and long parades. I'm sorry. I love you guys. I'm gonna miss you so much. I grew up with just girls, no boys, and I feel like I gained two little brothers this year. I wouldn't have had a great year without you two, and I love you both so much.
Hello, my name is Samantha Valdez. I'm the Hopkins Raspberry Festival Princess. To my darling Jenna, you're always the sweetest little girl I've ever met, and you always had a sweet thing to say to me, and that always put a smile on my face. I remember the first time I met you, you came running up to me and said, "We're like sisters because we had matching dresses." I love the way that you're always so enthusiastic about everything, and I will miss you so much. Renee, you have wonderful children, and you raise them so well. Thank you so much for all your help this year, and thank you for encouraging Jenna to run as a candidate, because if not, I would have missed so much, especially this year with her as her junior princess. So thank you so much.
All right. Good evening, everyone. I am the Hopkins Raspberry Festival Queen, Megan Hinderman, and I'm going to address our junior queen, Jada, here. I couldn't have been blessed with four more exceptional little brothers and sisters, and I say that because I'm the youngest of my family, so I don't know what it's like to have younger siblings. And it was a blessing this year. I loved it. They have demonstrated so much maturity this year. I'm so impressed and proud to call you part of my royal family. Jada, my little queen, very fitting title for you, might I say. Her charm has advanced so much this year. I'm so proud of you personally and happy to be with you on that float all year long. Erica, I'm jealous of her hair every parade and event we go to, and it looks fabulous. Her charm has excelled so much this year, and there's never a dull moment. I can't wait to see what the future brings you. Thank you.
Thank you, girls. The royalty coronation for Kirsten, Samantha, and Megan will take place tomorrow night at the Hopkins Center for the Arts. The event starts at 7 p.m., so please take the time to come and wish them farewell at their coronation.
The junior program has been around for many years. Many children in our community have been involved in the festival, and at this time, we would like to invite past Hopkins Raspberry Festival junior royalty to come to the stage and introduce themselves.
My name is Kellen Showers, and I was the 2003-2004 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Queen.
Hi, my name is Megan Woodruff.
Hi, my name's Megan Woodruff. I was the 2007-2008 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Queen.
Hi, I'm Olivia K. Gallagher. I'm the 2007-2008 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Princess, and I'm so glad to be here. Oh yeah, and good luck, juniors.
Hello, I'm Joseph Hollis, and I'm the 2006-2007 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior King.
Well, I'm Nick Newton. I was the 1992-1993 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Prince.
And I am Greg Smith. I was a 1963-64 Junior Prince.
Count on Greg. Thank you, Greg. And thank you, Junior Royalty. And we also have some visiting royalty from neighboring communities with us here tonight. If you would like to come up on stage, you can introduce yourself as well. You can come right through the stairs here, and I can get you up here. I'll give this to you, and you can just head right in the middle. Thank you.
Hi, and good evening, everyone. I'm Brianna Skolzacik, and I'm Miss Lonsdale.
Hi, I'm Caitlin Carlson, and I'm the junior ambassador.
Hi, I'm Danielle, and I'm a Miss Lonsdale princess.
I'm Samantha, and I'm Miss Lonsdale princess.
Hi, I'm DeMarco Robinson, and I'm a junior ambassador.
Hi, I'm Kalima Robinson, and I'm a junior ambassador for St. Louis Park.
Hi, my name is Anna Alicia, and I'm a ambassador for St. Louis Park.
Hi, my name is Megan Aguilar, and I'm delighted to be a Northeast Junior Ambassador.
Hello, everyone. My name is Sophia Hammer, and I'm proud to be a Northeast Junior Ambassador.
Hi, my name is Madison Frank. I'm excited to be a Northeast Junior Ambassador.
Well, Stephanie Bagstead has been running the junior program for 5 years now, and it still amazes her how much the children learn from each other in a small time frame. Shy children tend to jump big hurdles, and very spirited children learn to work within a group setting. By the end of the program, all of the children walk away with great memories, great life skills, and of course, riding the candidate float for the Grand Day Parade. Stephanie wants you to know that she has had a lot of fun working with all the candidates and their families this year. Stephanie will miss all of the little smiling faces, and most definitely, all the silly little moments that they have shared together throughout the program. Thank you, Stephanie.
Yes, we appreciate everything you've done again, Stephanie. Let's see. And at this time, we're going to start hearing our current junior royalty give their farewell addresses. We'll begin with our junior prince, Jalen Tremel.
Good evening. Thank you, everyone, for coming tonight. My name is Jalen Tremel, and I am the 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Prince. I have had so much fun this past year being the prince. I cannot believe how fast the year has gone. Thanks to John and Joan for always talking to us and keeping us smiling and waving during the parades, Luke, Jenna, and Jada. I am so glad that you are new friends, Megan, Kirsten, and Sam. Thank you for being so nice to us. You are all very funny and pretty, and I'm glad that you were my queen and princesses. I hope that I will still get to see you a lot. I want to say thank you to my mom for bringing me to all of the parades and events. I love you, Mom. And thanks to Tasia, my sister, for coming with to getting me candy during the parades. I think that the new prince will enjoy his time as much as I enjoyed mine. One more time, hi, my name is Jalen Tremmel, and I am the 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Prince.
Come on down here.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Prince.
Jalen Tremmel. And next, we're going to be hearing from our Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Princess, Jenna Bazzeo.
Hi, my name is Jenna Bazdale, and I'm the Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Princess. It all started with riding in the Raspberry Parade on a convertible, and it was hot. Then came the Minneapolis Aquatennial, the first time we rode on the Raspberry Float. The parade was cool. With lights, I have had a lot of fun going to the parades all over Minnesota. My favorite parade, besides Raspberry, of course, was the defeat of Jesse James. We got to see a bank raid. It was cool with real horses, but my favorite part of Raspberry was being with my royal family. We had so much fun, no matter where we were. I also had I also had fun volunteering at the Hopkins Activity Center for the New Year's Eve party, the VFW Christmas party, where we even saw Santa Claus, and at the Hopkins Fire Department open house, where I served ice cream. Thank you.
Sorry.
I already enjoyed representing the city of Hopkins. Thank you, Hopkins, for letting me be the junior princess. Also, thank you, Julie, for letting us carpool with you. And thank you, John and Joan, for the pizza pool party. One more time, my name is Jenna Bazdale, and I'm the I'm the 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Princess.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Princess, Jenna Bazdale.
Next, we have Junior King Luke Endress.
Hi, my name is Luke, and this last year I have had the great pleasure of being the Hopkins Raspberry Junior King. I have seen so many interesting places and done so many fun things. My favorite event was the fire department open house because I was able to go up in the cherry picker and go so, up higher than the fire station so that I could see three water towers. I think it was Megan's favorite, too. My favorite parade was the Nokia Night Halloween Parade because all of the floats were lit up and all of the street lights were turned off. I have learned a lot about Hopkins and what a great festival this is. Almost every place I went, people always said that the Raspberry Festival was one of their favorite parades. Being Junior King has taught me to not be so shy, and I have met so many great people. For example, at the Hudson Pepper Fest, I met the Prince of the West Wind, who showed me his whipping gun and a special knife that he received from a family as a gift. In the past year, I have met some special people whom I will miss. My royal family, Megan, Sam, and Kirsten. You always took care of me and made me feel special. Jada, Chaylin, and Jenna. You always found fun ways to pass the time when we were just waiting. Joan, you gave me way too many kisses. And John, just so you know, I really am the king. I want to give special thanks to the float drivers who were always putting the float back together. At least the float never tipped over, thanks to you, Jeff. A special thanks to you, Aubrey, for always having me in the right place at the right time, keeping my hands out of my pockets and looking like a king. You get bonus points for bringing your dog along. I want to thank my mom, dad, and family for coming to see me at all my events. I also want to thank the Raspberry Festival Board for having such a great opportunity. It was fun eating hot dogs, making spaghetti, and getting to know you. I know I will always be part of the Raspberry Festival. Good luck to this year's candidates. I hope you have as great of a time as I did, but don't eat as many donuts. Now, one more time, I am Luke Enders, the 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Junior King.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior King, Luke Endress.
And finally, we have our Junior Queen, Jada Gordon.
Hello, everybody. Hello, everybody. And thank you for coming tonight. My name is Jada Gordon, and I'm the Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Queen. Throughout the past year, we have been to 17 parades across Minnesota and even one in Wisconsin. We also participated in many other events this year. One of my favorite events this year was our first one, the Minneapolis Aquatennial, because all the floats were lit up and we got to stay up way past our bedtime. I also enjoyed going to the Twins game where we got to sing the seventh inning stretch. And be on the jumbo screen. I would like to thank all the drivers and chaperones for all their hard work this year, and to my family for supporting me. For the final time, I'm Jada Gordon, and I'm 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Queen.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Queen, Jada Gordon.
Junior Royalty, will you please come forward and wave as we present one final look at all of our 2009-2010 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Royalty. Prince Jalen Trummel, Princess Jenna Bezdeo, King Luke Endress, and Queen Jada Gordon. Oh, sorry. Yes, they deserve a standing ovation.
And it's always so sad to see them go, but exciting to see who will become their successors. Moment has come to find out who will be the 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Royal Family.
Thank you, judges. We will begin our royal family with the junior prince. The 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival junior prince, Anthony Olson. Jalen, come on up, Anthony. Both of you stand and wave real quick.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Prince, Anthony Olson.
All right, Princess. All right, Anthony.
And introducing the 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Princess, Mia Wilcox. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Princess, Mia Wilcox.
All right. And now we have our 2010-2000 Junior King. Our 2010-2011 Junior King is Sam Rolls. Please come on up stage.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior King, Sam Rolls. Introducing your 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Queen, Claire Nicholson. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Queen, Claire Nicholson.
Oh. We look forward to seeing you all at the Grand Day Parade this Sunday at 1 p.m. Please show your support by cheering on the junior candidates and the new royal family. This will be a very special day for all of them.
And before we bring the royalty up front again all together, we'd like to remind you of a couple things. Everyone is invited to join us for a reception and dance, honoring all of the candidates in the cafeteria.
So could we please have the parents of the newly crowned junior royalty meet Aubrey Yunker, our royalty coordinator, in front of the stage for some quick introductions? And then we look forward to seeing you all at the candidate float on Sunday. Thanks again, candidates. You all did a great job.
And ladies and gentlemen, pleasure to introduce you to the 2010-2011 Hopkins Raspberry Festival Junior Royalty. We have Prince Anthony Olson, Junior Princess Mia Wilcox, Junior King Sam Rolls, and Junior Queen Claire Nicholson. You four want to take a wave?
You can. Why don't you guys stand up and stand in the middle? Give a big wave. Thank you. That concludes our portion. Why don't we all head to the cafeteria for the reception?